I went through medical school, a place called Downstate Medical Center in Brooklyn, the other side of New York City. And while I was there, in college, I took an assistantship with a professor of microbiology at New York University, passing cultures, doing scut work, but that was also useful to me. That is, gave me some familiarity with bacteriology. And in medical school, I also, did some playing around. I spent a summer working in the microbiology laboratory at the medical school, this time doing virology. I met some interesting people who were doing virology at the time. Then after medical school, or let's say the last year of medical school, of course, one has to decide what do you do from there. And the normal process is one takes an internship. I don't remember exactly what my list of priorities was, but I did not get my top choices. I did get an internship in Cleveland at a hospital called Cleveland Metropolitan General. And the significance of that is that the head of pediatrics at the time was a man named Fred Robbins, who had won a part of a Nobel Prize in for cultivating viruses in cell culture. So, of course, I met him, and I didn't work with him, actually, but certainly had the opportunity to talk to him and to other people. And by the time I was finished with my internship, I knew I wanted to do something, I wanted to continue what I had decided at age 15, and the question was what to do. That would have been about 1957. And at that time, there was still a military draft. I was all set to go into the Air Force, actually. I had gone through the physicals, et cetera, because I had sort of an interest in flying. But then I heard of something called the Epidemic Intelligence Service, which is part of the Centers for Disease Control. And it was an accident. I heard about it from someone who had been an intern in Cleveland. And so I decided to apply to the EIS. And ultimately was accepted, so I was able to get out of military service by joining the public health service, or as it was humorously called, the Yellow Berets. But in any case, that enabled me to go down to Atlanta, to the CDC, and to study epidemiology, which is an aspect of infectious diseases which is critical. That is, understanding disease epidemics, not only the microbiology. At CDC, after the epidemiology course, they give you an assignment. Now, the assignments are variable. Some of them are to state health departments. Some of them are in Atlanta, that is, being on the staff or being in one of the units of the CDC. And there were a few special assignments to places that were neither state health departments nor CDC. And one of those was to the Wistar Institute in Philadelphia. Now, it so happened that by that time, I was reading fairly extensively in the scientific literature, I had read some articles by a scientist named Hilary Koprowski. He was at that time at Letterly Laboratories and was working on polio and rabies vaccines. And I had read that he was leaving Letterly and going to become director of the Wistar Institute. Now, the assignment at the Wistar Institute, curiously, was in something called the Anthrax Investigations Unit, because at that time, Philadelphia was the center, so to speak, of anthrax in this country. The reason being that Philadelphia then had a major clothing industry, and they would import goat hair from the Indian subcontinent, many of which lots were contaminated with anthrax. And so workers were picking up anthrax, getting infected, mainly skin infections. And so the anthrax unit of the CDC was stationed in Philadelphia. And so I recall the interview I had with the then head of EIS, Alexander Langmuir, talking about assignments, and he was astonished that somebody wanted to go to Philadelphia, one, and two, work on anthrax, which was kind of an abstruse subject. And of course, at the time, you know, the apocryphal tombstone of W.C. Fields, rather here than in Philadelphia. So that going to Philadelphia was, you know, was not like going to a scenic place. And indeed, I was probably the only one who wanted to go there. But I figured that if I went to the Wistar Institute, I would have a chance to work with Koprowski. And indeed, that's exactly what happened. I did quite a lot of anthrax, and that's another story which I'll be glad to tell you about. But shortly after I arrived, and indeed shortly after he arrived at the Wistar, I went to see him and offered my services, so to speak. Much to my pleasure, he readily accepted and incorporated me into his polio laboratory. So that from August 1957 on, I was doing both polio and anthrax as a member of the Public Health Service.